As politicians return to Canberra tonight after the long winter recess, the Coalition has paid up its debt to Independent Senator Jacqui Lambie, having delivered the government the vote it needed to pass its centrepiece tax package. It today met her demands to absolve Tasmania of a multi-million dollar debt.
A $157 million debt wiped away with the stroke of a pen.
Well done.
The Coalition writing off Tasmania's decades-old public housing bill.
This deal wouldn't have happened without Jacqui Lambie.
Well, this deal would not have happened without a chorus of voices.
In return for the Independent Senator's support of its $158 billion tax plan.
Do you wish you'd ask them for more?
I have no doubt whatsoever, mate, that I'm going to be coming back asking for money whilst I still have that, or whilst Tasmania has that balance of power.
The self-described Jacqui Lambie 3.0 backing two more government policies, the national rollout of cashless debit cards and drug tests for New Start recipients, which she'd like extended to politicians and public servants.
If you've got nothing to hide up there in that big White House, then it's now your turn. That'll keep the backbenchers in line.
I've got no problem with it.
Yeah, I'm happy to do a test right now if you've got a swab on you.
Up before it, I'll get up and afraid of nothing. Yeah. Bulletproof we are.
The cards quarantine 80% of New Start payments for pre-approved purchases, like food, clothing and utilities, with only 20% of payments able to be withdrawn as cash.
Now, we've been trialling this in communities around the country and it's working.
It won't create a job. It humiliates people. It's not a sensible policy.
What the government needs to do right now, and I think it knows deep down that this is what it needs to do, is lift the rate of New Start, lift it significantly.
The Reserve Bank governor repeating his previous warning that tax cuts alone aren't enough to stimulate Australia's slowing economy, again calling for an immediate investment in infrastructure projects as growth falls to its lowest level since the global financial crisis.
Well, I completely reject that proposition. We're not at odds with the Reserve Bank governor. Monetary policy and fiscal policy is heading in the same direction.
Setting up yet another showdown after the five-week winter break.
So the test is on then next week. Whose side are they on when it comes to getting people off welfare into work?
The question for the government this week is, where's its wages policy? Where's its policy to grow the economy?
Brett Mason, SBS World News.